we've all felt sad, but that is not depression. Many people spend a transitory or circumstantial period of sadness, but that is not depression. Depression is not what it seems. Depression is a mental disorder that can be diagnosed reliably and that can be treated by psychiatrists and psychologists in a complementary way. No drugs are required to deal with depression in most cases. Psychotherapy is usually enough, but drugs are reserved for psychiatric care in more severe cases. The origin of depression is complex, since genetic, biological, psychological, and social factors influence. Among them, the biological factors are the ones that deserve special attention, including psychoneuroimmunology, which raises a bridge between strictly biological and psychological approaches. Multiple evidence indicates that depressive episodes are associated not only with changes in the neurotransmission of the central nervous system, but also with structural changes in the brain. Produced through neuroendocrine, inflammatory, and immunological mechanisms, depression is frequent. In fact, the World Health Organization, WHO, notes that more than 300 million people could be diagnosed with a depressive disorder. This is definitely an important issue, and being able to correctly identify depression is even more important. In this video, you will know 5 signs of depression. 1. Hypoactivity or hyperactivity. A depressive patient tends to abandon many of the activities he previously performed and resign himself to demotivation. It is very common for a person with depression to lose energy and therefore abandon many activities. Now, the opposite reality can also occur. A depressed person could choose to work too much and keep busy all day just to avoid one thing: thoughts. 2. Physical ailments not related to a disease. It has to do with muscle aches that appear suddenly without a specific reason. Migraines, frequent indigestion, sudden dizziness, and discomforts like that. You go to the doctor and find nothing abnormal in your body, but the discomfort does not stop appearing. This may be a sign that you actually have depression. 3. Cancel and postpone meetings with others. If you have a friend who suddenly, for no apparent justifiable reason, has some time putting off social activities, this is another indicator. The patient with depression self-excludes himself from the groups and prefers to isolate himself, spend time alone. The depressed does it without explicitly planning it, just start feeling tired to go out and make thousands of excuses to interact with others. 4. Watch too much television, internet, or social networks. Watching too much television or spending too much time on the computer or with your eyes on the mobile phone can be symptoms of depression. That obsessive relationship that the depressed develops with the screens is a way of isolating oneself from the real social environment and forgetting everything for a moment. Over time, the depressed patient will watch more TV or on the computer. When one spends too much time in front of a screen, one can become someone very self-absorbed who does not connect with his surroundings. And it is a vicious circle. Recent studies have shown that social networks can be a trigger for feelings of inferiority, frustration, and subsequent depression. 5. Make mistakes often. When there is depression, the mind works more slowly. It is also very common that there is difficulty concentrating or ordering ideas and planning activities. That is why depressed people usually make many small mistakes on a day-to-day basis. Continuous errors or mistakes, such as forgetfulness, confusion about simple matters, distractions, and difficulty learning, frequent clumsiness, among others. It is as if that person did not finish being totally present in the here and now. All these symptoms of depression are generally very subtle for those who suffer from them, and for those who are part of their environment. If they appear, especially when they are simultaneous, it may be time to stop, look at what is happening, and seek help. Despite being such an important disease, it does not seem that society is prepared to recognize it or to seek professional help when it occurs. According to the ESEMED study in Spain, 59% of patients with depression do not go to the doctor in the last year. Among them, up to 76% do not receive any type of treatment for their depression. This is why depression is considered a stealthy killer. If you think that you, a friend, or family member of yours has depression, talk to someone and seek professional help. I hope you learned something new today. If you want to watch more interesting videos like this, click on the video given on your screen. If you still have some questions left, let us know in the comments section below. Don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.